In this video, we will talk about plate tectonics and mountain building. But first, let's review what happens at the three types of plate boundaries. First, divergent plate boundaries. Remember what happens here. The plates spread apart at the mid-ocean ridges, like the mid-Atlantic ridge. What forms there? Basalt. What kind of faults do you think you're going to get? If you're pulling apart, you're going to get tension, so you get normal faults. And you generally have shallow earthquakes. Second type of plate boundary, convergent plate boundary, where plates come together. For continent-continent convergent plate boundaries, when two continents collide, what's going to happen? You're going to get mountains, like the Himalayas. You get earthquakes. You get granites. And you get faults when the two plates come together. What about at subduction zones, where you have an oceanic plate going, say, underneath a continent? You're going to get volcanic activity, andesitic volcanoes, which are explosive. You're going to get shallow to very deep earthquakes, up to 700 kilometers. And you're also going to get reverse faults, or low-angle reverse faults, called thrust faults. And the third type of plate boundary, the transform fault boundary, that's where plates move by each other. What happens? Major thing that happens here will be earthquakes. Think of the San Andreas Fault. In 50 million years or so, San Francisco will be due west of LA because of the movement along the San Andreas Fault. Now we will talk about mountain building in more detail as it relates to plate tectonics. But first, a little bit more information on the continents. The continents are composed of the continental shields. These are the oldest part of the continents. They're generally Precambrian rocks, and they occur in the center part of the continent. In North America, they're in what's called the Canadian Shield. These shields are surrounded by younger mountain belts, like the Appalachians and the Rockies. So how do we relate these mountains to plate tectonics? Well, some mountains are volcanic mountains, like the Cascades. They occur above subduction zones. The Cascades are in the northwestern United States. An example volcano there would be Mount St. Helens. We have continent-continent collision mountain belts like the Appalachians and Himalayas. Now, there's something very interesting about the relationship between plate tectonics and mountains. And the best way to illustrate that is to think about what's called the Wilson cycle. So let's go back in time. And let's start off about 550 million years ago or so. At that time, North America had a very similar situation to today. But at about 500 million years ago, the situation changed. And we started to get subduction underneath the East Coast, or what is now the East Coast of North America, and plates started to come together. If you got subduction then, what do you think happened? Well, you got volcanoes. At 375 million years ago, the continents came together and there was collision. And what happened? The Appalachians formed. And that resulted in the supercontinent of Pangaea, which was Wegner's original idea. At 200 million years, the continents split apart and we got the current Atlantic Ocean as we see it today. So, based on this cycle, what do you think will happen in the future?